Yesterday, President Yoweri Museveni made a mini reshuffle in cabinet where he dropped five ministers and appointed five others. He followed it with drastic changes in the top leadership of the Uganda People's Defense Forces, which saw General Muhoozi Kainerugaba take position as the new Chief of Defense Forces of the UPDF. Agnes Nandutu, the outgoing Minister of State for Karamoja, is among those who lost their slots in cabinet. She has asked President Yoweri Museveni to forgive her where she went wrong during her tenure, but says that her ouster will not stop her from supporting the NRM party.
Not catch my colleagues who have remained in cabinet. I want to wish them well, and I am happy that they have remained. I'm also happy for the new entrants that the president has appointed. I want to wish them well. Where I have gone wrong, I ask the president to forgive me.
Nandutu applauded President Museveni for according her an opportunity to serve in cabinet, which was way above her expectations.
Okay, for me I have nothing much. I just want to thank the head of this country, President Yoweri Museveni, for the opportunity he gave me to serve at the highest level in government as a cabinet minister. I am very grateful and I thank him for that opportunity. While many people in the country saw nothing in me, President Yoweri Museveni saw something in me and appointed me to be one of the 100 most important or very important persons in this country. And I've done my best to serve this country.
Members of Parliament have drawn mixed reactions on the changes which were effected both in the cabinet and the army. Some tried to read the mind of the appointing authority as others expressed their expectations.
As members of Parliament, we are ready to work with the new cabinet. And we had some surprises like appointment of the CDF, Honorable General Muhoozi Kainerugaba, because some people thought he's planning to retire, because we can see PLU is really gaining ground.
I'm not going to comment if that was his decision. He knows better. He has a big antenna on the ground to know what happened about the iron sheets, about the Karamoja. So he took a decision and I respect it.
Was it not embarrassing to
keep them in cabinet? No, not really, because they had natural justice must have to prevail.
Mr. Bargari has been a business person, though really a good mobilizer, but he has been also a good marketeer. So he has to know that at the moment he can't do business and politics at the same time.
It's like most of the ministers who and all cabinet bounce back, except for a few newcomers or new kids on the block for that matter. I want to congratulate the new honorable members of parliament who got the appointment, like honorable Abel Lilian, honorable Fiona Nyamutoro.
Medad Segona, the Busiro East County member of parliament, has described the appointment of Muhoozi Kainerugaba as chief of defense forces as part of the president's ploy to deflate him from contesting against him in the 2026 general elections.
But he's a clever chap. One, he had empowered his son so much, and he realized that the speed at which the son was moving is not the speed that he wanted. Because Museveni does not want his son to run for presidency in 2026.
The same opinion is shared by other MPs who believe the appointment of top leaders of the Patriotic Leagues of Uganda is aimed at trimming their political ambition.
The president trying to tame the MK or the PLOU and say, I think you have done enough, I have a race to complete, and I will hold you back and complete, and you will come on the further. This is what we are seeing, that enough awareness has been made. It's now time to continue with with my activities. You have done enough awareness, and you will come definitely after.
However, Michael Mawanda, one of the top leaders of PLU, has denied claims that the appointment of Muhoozi as CDF would deflate the strength of PLU, saying Muhoozi's latest appointment draws him closer to power.
The commander-in-chief, at the same time the president of the Republic of Uganda, has trust in PLU. He picked some of our colleagues to work with him so that we can bring change in this country. So as PLU, we are happy and we congratulate our colleagues, and we know that we shall give a contribution to this country.
Mawanda also insists that Muhoozi's appointment as CDF doesn't interfere with provisions in the UPDF Act that bars serving officers from participating in partisan politics, arguing that PLU is not a political party but rather a civic organization.
He is not supposed to participate in partisan politics, but ours as PLU, we are not a political party. We are a civic organization that is non-partisan, non-denominational and non-sectarian.
Asuman Basalirwa, the Bujiri municipality MP, decried the supposed continued sidelining of Muslims by President Museveni and called on Muslims that have been hobnobbing with the president to pick lessons from his latest appointments.
As a Muslim community, we continue to be disappointed that Mr. Museveni continues making appointments in total disregard of the Muslim community. Already, the cabinet has very few Muslims. The larger public sector has very few Muslims. But even when he makes a mini reshuffle or cabinet reshuffle, still the Muslim community is left out.
Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.